Hello everyone, this is Noble John. Welcome to another episode of ARK Scorched Earth single player. I've just been running around trying to get all my dinosaurs to defecate. That's kind of fun to say. Get my dinosaurs to defecate. I still have trouble with this ladder. I have no idea how long this glitch is going to go on. So I can't use the ladder. I've just been using my Lamantria, to take me back and forth. So it's just been sitting out in the back here. And I've been gathering up a lot of feces. Because I need to build myself my greenhouse. And up here, I tried to prepare myself. This guy back here, Dung, if you remember I tamed him in the previous episode. Him, her, it. It doesn't really have a gender. Small, small. Can you fit any more in you? Oh yeah, you can. Oh, perfect. 8.1. Dung was taking entirely too long to convert dung into fertilizer. I think it was actually something like an hour and a half and nothing had happened. And I couldn't tell if it was glitched or if I just needed to go and get some others. So I decided to get some others. I've picked up crap and feces. Crap was actually a level 36, so they do come in higher levels. Oops. I want to see if it went on there, not if it would go into my inventory. I have a medium one too. So your weight is full. That means you are probably pretty empty. Why don't you take the medium one? And the small one. What's your weight at? No, you can take more. But yeah, now I should have myself three little fertilizer factories, which is a good thing. And I still can't pick them up, which doesn't really make any sense to me. Uh-oh, you're moving around now. I need to get some more feces for you. How much weight do you can carry now? 0.5 more and you're walking? How come you're not moving? You still got 1.2 left. You're not moving a bit. I do have you set to wander? Yeah, I do. Okay, so we got them doing our thing. We're going to put up our walls today. Let's see if we can get down here real quick. And it's really just been this fun exercise of jumping on my dinosaurs and pressing Z. Not ready to defecate yet. And this one doesn't really matter because their feces are really small anyway. Wait, who just pooped? Oh, Jorby. Jorby always seems to do that. Every time I jump on another dinosaur and tell him to poop, nothing happens and then I hear a poop noise and it's always Jorby. But yeah, they're not defecating. But every time I do that little flapping thing, Daniel does that. I got him bumped up one extra level because of something I was doing a bit ago. So I got his health higher up than before. I think it was sitting at... Ooh, you just pooed. I'm usually not this excited about dinosaur poop, but I am right now because I need the fertilizer. Wait, why do I check your inventory? Poop! Not ready to defecate, and I think you just did defecate, didn't you? Yeah, this is kind of weird. I can't even see the poop. But somewhere around here, there it is, I see it. I can still pick it up even though I can't see it. It's kind of fun. But yeah, so we're gonna stick all that poop up in the other dung beetle in a second. Inside of crap, I believe. Crap, feces, and dung. Good names, right? I think they're good names. But we did go out, we gathered ourselves a lot of crystal, and we had to go and learn all the engrams for, not in here, in the crafting thing. No, I guess they're in this. Structures, crafting, greenhouse. To learn all of these things, we also had to learn all of the stone and all of the wood and engrams. And you can see it was like quite a few. I've got the foundations, the walls, the angled walls, the sloped roofs, the doorways, the windows. And then the reinforced windows and doors in order to learn any of the greenhouse stuff. I mean, I didn't have to learn this in order to learn the wall, for example. But yeah, I had to learn both the wooden wall and the stone wall in order to learn how to do the greenhouse wall. So there was a lot of engrams I'm never going to use. But we do finally have these in place. I do have a lot of walls here, but I think I'm going to need more. Because if I look down at the bottom, I actually want to make it... the straight walls, I want to do two stories of those. So this is going to be, I think, four foundations deep. Okay, so we got the one that you're standing on, Daniel. So that's one, two, three, four, and then three across, four back, and then three across again. So quick math will be 4, 8, plus 6, 14. It'll be 14 per floor. So I think I might need to do more crystal as well. Did I already make myself a doorway? I did. Doorway and a door. I do have the four roofs across, but I do not have the sloped roofs yet. So I'm actually going to need So if I'm using a doorway on the first floor, I'm gonna need 13 more for that floor, but then I'm also gonna need two more. Okay. 15. I need 15 more of these, and I can only do 13 more. I might have to gather more crystals. I think we'll get most of this done here. Let me make those walls real quick, and I won't be able to do the sloped roofs, will I? Yeah, it's telling me I'm already out of those. And what am I going to run out of? Crystal? Okay. So I guess I can show you some of the things that have been troubling me as I've been doing this build. Let's just get some of those in our... Actually, no, they're almost done. Let's just go ahead and grab them when they're all done. To build these things, I don't know if you just saw, we need metal ingots, which we do have quite a few of remaining, 180 left. We also need crystal, which we have to get from the mountains, and then cementing paste, which I had very little of and didn't really know how to build. I keep forgetting, like every time I need to do cementing paste, I forget how it's built. But yeah, we came out here. This is where it's built. And you can see in here that it takes chitin or keratin, four of those, and then eight stone. And we've actually been really fortunate. How we have found like a really easy way to get stone is on Doug. So I'm actually going to drop all this stuff, which, I don't know, it might seem foolish. Can you move? Oh, just barely. And that might be all we need you to do, because when we move over here, we're just close enough. Turn you to the side just a little. I think this is close enough. Yeah, that'll do. Automatically breaks the stone nearby and fills his inventory to weight far exceeding his limit. But look how much stone and sand we get from that. That was from one rock. As you remember, I just cleared out his entire inventory. So yeah, Doug does this really good for stone. And then we've been taking Salty out, and we've discovered that killing thorny dragons gives us something like 250 chitin. No, sorry, keratin. And yeah, I don't think I've ever been able to find a source of keratin quite that high before with any dinosaur. So I've considered myself quite fortunate. There was a poop right there, wasn't there, Daniel? I knew you were hiding it. Oh, did you just poop again, Jorby? Thank you. Daniel, we're going to have you move, though. Let's put you over here for now. Land. Okay. Let's see if we... Another poop. Medium poop. We need all this fertilizer. Maybe we should start fertilizing all this stuff now, because I've got fertilizer in my inventory. I'm starving. Fertilizer. Fertilizer. As you see, as I go through, all the plants start to grow. This one's seeded, irrigated, seedling. Okay, it takes a little bit. I'm going to say game ticks, but it's not Minecraft. So it's, I don't really know internally what causes it to start to turn into a seedling. But yeah, we've got all those. Perfect. Okay, so here is a place. Let's actually get this stuff set up. I've actually... I don't know if I knew this ever, or if I'd forgotten it. I'm not quite sure, but I was just watching one of Antique's videos, who I talked about in the last video, because he was talking about gathering wyvern eggs. So I went and watched one of his videos on that, which was actually pretty informative and entertaining. So maybe you guys can go check that out too and give him some support, because he's also a YouTuber who needs the attention. So yeah, send him some love for me. But yeah, he had the rare mushrooms on his hotbar, and I didn't remember that you could eat rare mushrooms. They do not spoil at all, but I don't have them in abundance right now. 24 is all that I've got, so I might not continue to do that for very long until I get some more to replace them. Let me get this stuff at least in place, because I want to be able to do the first floor. So let me do my first walls. And I have never built myself a greenhouse. So I'm actually pretty excited to see how this thing turns out. I have seen it on other people's channels, but never on my own. Okay, number two is the door. And then... Okay, so our first floor is done. Three. Pop our door. Perfect. Excellent. So we have enough to do ourselves two floors, but we don't have enough to do the roof quite yet. That's unfortunate. But yeah, you can see kind of the general shape. I do want to have this thing be two floors because I want to be able to put some storage in here. And if I put some storage in here, a large chest, it'll exceed the height of a single floor. I actually have one. I think it's in my inventory right now. Yeah, it is. Let me pop that in real quick. And stick it right over here, I think, is where I want to put it. I can't actually tell if that's straight to the wall. Yeah. That'll do. Is it centered? It's kind of centered. Good enough. So this thing is gonna be where we store all this kind of stuff. All the extra fertilizer, which I don't have really a lot of extra right now. Because, as you saw, all these things here only have one in them right now. I'm going to need a lot more to make them good. So, yeah, we got that right there, our storage, which you can see exceeds that height there. Let's see what else we got to put up right now. We have these. So I can put one on each side, but I still can't do... So that'll go on this end. Oh, dang it. Did it really do that? Oh, man. Oh... That bothers me. Dang it. I cannot believe it did that. I thought I was already placing it in the right spot, but apparently not. It looks like the this particular one went to the wrong foundation. Ugh. That sucks. I really don't like that noise that it makes either when it breaks. Kind of a high-pitched shrieking sound. But yeah, so we're going to have to actually make one, two... And then because we're going to want kind of a sloping roof on either side, we're going to do another wall here and another wall there. So we're going to need four more walls and eight more sloped roofs, but we should have enough with everything else. I don't know if we can make anything else with the material we've just got back from that. Let me see. Structures. Can I do another wall? I want to see if I can place a wall and not have it be in the wrong spot. Then I'll need two more. Okay, let's see. Number three. Nope. A little further. Further. Come on. Is that in the right spot? Excellent. They're all lined up now. Perfect. Those are the ones I'm worried about because these are the ones that have two foundations between. That little seam right there. And so I want to make sure that it's on the right one. So that's good because everything from there on out just goes on the ones below it. So we'll be good there. But it looks like I'm going to have to gather some more crystal. Actually, let me put these things in place first. Just to kind of give you the idea of the shape. That's going to be number two. And number one will go right up there when it's ready, but it's not ready right now. But yeah, that'll kind of give you the idea of what I'm going for in this area. And I think that'll be pretty good. These things don't have any... Yeah, no greenhouse effect. Jorby just laid another poop. But yeah, we're going to have to go on to... Daniel, I just got myself stuck in that door. There we go. Where are you, Daniel? Let's pop all these in here real quick. These, we don't need any more of those, and that. Actually, we need to put that in there too, don't we? Stick this stuff back in my hot bar. Sure. And I gotta put that poop up there. I've actually been clearing a lot of weight from my inventory because, it helps me to gather crystal faster. Let me get it back up here. How are you guys doing? Did you get any more fertilizer? Do you need any more feces? You do not have enough weight for a medium. That's a medium. Medium. Small. Small. Wait, you can hold a small, can't you? Oh, I guess it's a little higher than that. The small ones are 0.3. And you can hold a small, but nothing more. Wait, did you have any? No, you don't have any fertilizer. None of you do? You got some more weight. Yeah, not enough for me to be able to put a medium on you. There's like 1.5 pounds. And you're all full up too. Okay. So, I guess you're going to have to hold it for now. Sorry. Give you some more stamina. And fly down here and land. Thank you. Where'd you go, Daniel? Oh, yeah, we put you around the corner. Oh, another poop. No, we're not going to pick it up because we're going to go flying anyway. But yeah, as I just learned, as we're doing this and trying to get all of our poop, I've learned that we don't actually have a lot of dinosaurs right now. In our regular Survival ARK series, we actually have so many dinosaurs that it's really easy to get a lot of poop really fast. I don't even have to jump on any of them and force them to poop. It's just everywhere I go, there's dinosaur poop. They're just constantly pooping because there's like 40 of them. But yeah, when in this game, we've only got like, I think at most 8? Maybe if you include the dung beetles, like up to 12. Let's see. I think I might already have that blueprint, but whatever. We did actually come across a really good one. There was a red drop, and I think I'm finally high enough level to pick up the red ones. I'm currently sitting at 73, almost 74. Which is pretty exciting because I think 75 is the highest, or the next level to gather the highest engrams for Scorched Earth. So I'm kind of excited to see that. Look at those thorny dragons, walking keratin factories. This is where I've been getting all the crystals, on this mountain right here. So as you come, I've already showed you when I was on my wolf. You just fly around, and right over here you can already see some. Well, I'm blocking it now. But yeah, right there there's crystals. There's green ones there. There's the white ones there. There's some more over there. So there's quite a few crystals in the area. I'm going to have to come down and pick up this guy. Take care of him. Anything that's going to be in my way as I'm gathering needs to die. He's not going to bother me, I don't think. I basically have to come and land. And then see if there's anything going to detect me and come. Yep. Hello, kitty. There looks like there's a lot more on this side than there is on that other side. Like where that white drop is. And that's usually about where I go and gather the stuff. Right over here, these crystals. Doesn't look like they've all regenerated yet. Yeah, you can see there's like not a lot here in this area. There's that Argy there, but I think it's still out of aggro range. What level are you, by the way? 64? Psh. Not very high. Oops. But yeah, we can gather the crystals right here and the rare mushrooms. This is the way we've been gathering them. And just fly from one to the next one being just right over next to that Argy, but we're not going to be able to grab that one. Let's see what... Oh, there's a rock monster right there. You see that? Yep. Oh, are you like bloody or are you just red? You look like you just read. Oh crap, that was another one. they weren't here the last time I was up here. Are there any more in this area? Because there's more crystal here that I really want to pick up. Hey, go down. Don't throw rocks at me. Thank you. Perfect. So yeah, we're just going to continue to gather some crystal and then head back and make ourselves the remainder of our greenhouse. See you in a sec. I'm sorry, I lied. I told you we were going to go back to base once we got the crystal. We only managed to get about 150 in that area because I had already cleared it recently. And apparently too recently, because when I logged off last, most of them did not regenerate. So I kind of have to let the area let it be for a bit and let it regenerate again. Is it here? Where is it? It's somewhere around here. Underneath that guy? Oh yeah, it looks like it's up here. Yep, there it is. Over here, I think you remember, there's a cool cave. And this cave is full of metal and crystal and obsidian and all kinds of wonders. And this cave, I actually kind of wanted to scope it out because I want to build not really a base, but like kind of a mini base at least, where I have a smithy out here. Probably closer to the entrance, but maybe like right around in this area. So I'd have like a little foundation here and then a smithy on top of it, because I don't think you can put them directly on the floor. And then I'd be able to take like an Ankylo or some other dinosaur that would gather a lot more crystals than, you know, the paltry amount I gather. As you can see, I'm only gathering 50 so far from 3 different crystals. And my melee damage is buffed. And so my gather rates are high too, but... As you can see, whoops, I'm going to have to drop the stone every time because I don't want that. I just want the crystals. And it'll probably still tell me I'm encumbered. Yep. Oh well. That'll still give me enough. 260 should still be enough for me to go and do some, potentially the remainder of what I've got to build. But yeah, I'd really like to have that in this area and then get myself an I don't know if it's going to be an Anki or a Dodic. Yeah, it would have to be an Anki because Dodic would give me more stone than the alternative. So yeah, an Anki in this area would give me a ton of crystal really fast. And then I can actually just craft the material directly in here and carry that back. So I wouldn't have to carry the weight of the crystal all the way back to my base like I'm doing right now. And that would actually be a lot more effective to just carry the build, the walls themselves, everything that I build from the crystal. So yeah, that's a thing that I'm going to do soon. The only trouble is I have not been able to see any Ankies in the area. And I still don't see any now. Actually, I should check and see, because the cave did go through to the other side of this mountain. I wonder if there's anything on the opposite end. We can check that real quick, because that would actually be really handy to have it be so close that I could potentially even lure it into the cave, like, you know, strike it once, maybe shoot it once, and then lure it in there, and then tame it inside. It would be a lot easier to protect it. Seeing a lot of dinosaurs in the area, but not any Ankies. Any on the wall up there? There's some sabertooths. An RG. Yeah, it doesn't look like I'm going to be fortunate enough to get him out here. This is just a bunch of predators. That's unfortunate. Oh, well. Yeah, we're just going to have to do it the other way. Try to bring it in after we've tamed it. Really wish I had a Quetzal. They don't even spawn on Scorched Earth, but oh well. We'll do what we can. See you back at base. What are you doing in there, Daniel? You don't fit in the greenhouse. I mean, you don't even know how big these RGs are until you put them in a greenhouse that's 3x4, and they make it look so small. This is how big an RG is. Now you know. I think, actually, one of the things I didn't think about, I wanted to do... wow, your turning radius is pretty pathetic. I want to put all these dung beetles inside of there, so I don't have to keep coming up here to get them, to get the fertilizer and things. So yeah, I'm just going to pick them up one by one and stick them inside before I put this roof on. It'd be kind of foolish of me to do it after I put the roof on and try to get them through the door, which I'm not even sure if they fit through the door. That's almost all of them. I'm going to see if I can get the last one. Can I? If I jump off, do I go off the edge? Yep. Daniel! Get me up there and keep me up there. Thank you, buddy. Dung. Wait, yep. You don't have any fertilizer. Let's take some of these heavy poops and see if you can follow me now. And you can. Let's see if you can fit through a door, though. Because you got in there. Can you get out? You got yourself in there. Come on. Squeeze through. Excellent. That is good enough. Let's keep you right there for now and stick all this poo back in you. And I think you're still set to wander, right? Okay, yeah. Just as long as it's following me, it's not currently not in wander state, but now it should be good. Drop it in here. Excellent. All of them are in there. We're going to have to actually go out, sadly enough, and gather some more crystal because the sloped roofs... Whoops. Rolled my middle mouse button. The sloped roofs, I think, cost... Whoops. Oh, that's an extra one. I was like, why is my hatchet in there? They cost more than the regular ones, so we were only able to make 5, and we're going to need 3 more. And they're going to take... See, I can already make more walls, but this thing... This takes 25, this takes 35 crystal. And I currently only have 25, so I'm going to have to gather... 80 more? That's not too bad. I'm going to gather more than that just in case I break something here or there. Hey, I didn't think about you getting in my way. Lyman, can you fly me or am I too heavy? Got in. Excellent. Okay. So let's see if we can finish up this build real quick. And one up in the middle there. This goes over here. The roofs go up on the top. At the top? Kind of looks like it's sunken in a little. Okay. We'll accept that, I guess. 3, 3, 3. And then we're going to have to do 4. Okay. Actually, well, you won't get stuck because all the roofs are going to come out, but... Nope, come on. I need you to be straight. Don't move. I just get so worried when I place these things that they're just going to wig out, freak out, do something stupid. Okay, so we've almost got them all. This side we can do just the one, and then we need to go get some more crystal. Excellent. Okay. Come on, Lymantria. Actually, why don't you come over here for a second again? And I'm going to see if I can get these dung beetles. Oh, it moved. Now I can get in and out. Okay. Does that mean you have fertilizer on you? Because you weigh less? No, you're just moving now. Couldn't move before. Here, have some more weight. I don't have any more poo for you. Sorry. None of you have fertilizer yet? That's pathetic. Let's get my Lymantria out of here. And back over to where it was. It's getting to be dark out. I actually want to check and see if any of these things have a greenhouse effect yet. Greenhouse effect, 300. Excellent. Are you at 300? You're at 0, 0, 0, which is what I expected because you don't have a roof over you yet. But that's good to know. We should be able to take care of that as soon as we have some more crystal. And that's dark. Let me gamma up. Perfect. We're going to go get some more crystal. We're just going to have to grab Daniel and then head on out. And I'll bring you guys back when we're about done with this greenhouse, which is already looking really nice. See you in a sec, guys. So we just leveled up to level 74. That's nothing I really want right now, but we've got our sloped roofs, and I don't know if you just saw, we also have 130 more. We have to fix that thing up in a sec, too. Probably not in this episode, maybe in a future one when it's further down, closer to being ruined. Let's try to get these up in place right now without breaking anything. Oh, we have done it. You getting the greenhouse? Yep, greenhouse effect, 300, 300, 300. Excellent. They still do have fertilizer, but we're going to need a lot more on them. Are any of you moving faster? You're moving faster. No, you're still just... full of poo. Why are you all full of poo and no fertilizer? Now that you're on camera, you're not doing it right. Let's move some of this stuff out of your inventory, then move it all back in and see if that, like, resets you or something. I don't know. Is that even a thing? We need you guys to give us fertilizer. Put it all back in. And you too. But I think... No, come on. Take it out. I don't know why they're not giving me more. Actually, let me pop that there. I don't know why I went into my dung beetles inventory to put my pick back into place, but it's a thing. And so is this a thing. Pretty excited about that. I've always wanted a greenhouse. I like it. It's it's not the prettiest. It's just kind of obvious the shape, but I like it. And it's practical. It has everything we need. We do have some room to put some more stuff in here if we wanted it. We do have room to put a lot of fertilizer in here once we actually have a lot of fertilizer. Once you guys start producing fertilizer. I gave you this perfectly good greenhouse. Give me some poop. I mean fertilizer. I gave you poop. So yeah, that's pretty cool. And we also need more poop, which means we need more dinosaurs. Let's take a look at this from the air again. Give me that. Thank you. Yeah. It looks pretty good from the air. Let me actually hit backspace so we get rid of all the names and stuff. Yeah, it doesn't fit with our Adobe stuff, but whatever. I like it anyway. It's still pretty cool. But yeah, actually, no, it just reminds me. I just found some stuff, that some cool gear that I wanted to tell you guys about. Excuse me, Daniel. Can I get behind you? Thank you. Over on our Thorny Dragon over here, we have now a Journeyman saddle. So it's a lot stronger than the one we had before. The armor rating is significantly higher. I don't remember what it was before. Probably like 20, 30. Now it's at 52.8. Let's give you more health. Because your health isn't very high. And give it backspace back. And then in here, I think. Yeah. We also managed to get ourselves a rocket launcher. And yeah, this is the original. 25. So it's more than double. 52. That's a good increase. No, not here. There's one. There's an engram. Not engram. Yeah, right here. The Mastercraft Mantis Saddle. Pretty excited about that. I need to tame myself a mantis now. That's a really cool find. But yeah, what do you guys think? I do need to tame some more dinosaurs, but I can't really think of what I want to do. I'm thinking about doing a T-Rex, but you know, T-Rexes aren't Scorched Earth. They're on Scorched Earth, but there's nothing new about a T-Rex. Where did that? There's a Moralotops. There was a Moralotops in the area that was pretty high level. You? You're level 12. Definitely not you. Where did it go? Oh, there's a lot of Moralotops over there. Maybe it's one of them. Whoa. 68, 36, 20. There it is. Female 120. Right there in the middle heading out. I'm kind of curious to tame that one. But I need to get Vulture Kibble to get a perfect tame on them. So that might be a little difficult. I'm going to have to get some vultures to do that. But yeah, a perfect level Moralotops would be awesome. I also need to get a Paraceratherium so I can get a platform saddle and a cannon and try to get myself a rock golem, because I think that'd be pretty sweet. But yeah, what do you guys think? What should I go for next? I still need to go get a wyvern egg. This is the whole reason that I built this greenhouse, is so I can start getting recipes. Making myself kibble and stuff like that. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. And if you are enjoying the series, be sure to subscribe for more Scorched Earth. Thank you guys so much for watching. Ooh, we're back here. So let's, yeah. Open that window from the outside. We've been meaning to do that for a while. Excellent. Hey, you need some more stuff. Use some more melee damage. You see all that rotten meat? We're gonna have to make some narcotics. Yeah, guys, we'll see you. Hold on. Nope, wrong button. What was it? K, there it is. We'll see you in the next episode. What are you looking at, Jorby? Say goodbye to the people. Bye. What are you looking at?